Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show, so if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hi everyone, welcome to a special edition of Google Plus Developers Live, part of the Google Developers Live program. We have a special show for you today, a special treat. We have a new participant. We have Oscar, the Hangout robot, a brainchild of Gus.
Yep. So I'm Gus, and I'm a developer advocate on the Google Plus team. And yeah, I'm really excited to be here for Google Developers Live. And Oscar is just a robot that I dug out of my parents' basement because I remembered that I had it around and right when I was learning how to create Hangout apps. And so in an afternoon, I just I put together a web server and then connected it to the Hangout app. And so hopefully when you click the commands within the Hangout app, it will move Oscar.
Cool. Yay, I see Oscar worked. Moving. And let's take a look at how that happens. We have some people joining us through the magic of cyberspace on the Hangout. So why don't we introduce the people who are joining us that way, who will be helping us control the robot. So starting with you, Emily.
Hi, I'm a software engineer. I do web and concurrent stuff.
Yes, and you had some really great questions last week, so you get to join us this week.
You get to join, bonus.
Earlier this week. And next to you is, of course, Gerwin.
Hi, I'm Gerwin, developer from Austria, and I love Hangouts, I love robots, so that's just perfect.
Great. So, switch over to Oscar's view, what Oscar's seeing. Oh, we can see Devin there.
Yep.
Hi, Devin. He's our volunteer robot handler who's helping us in case Oscar finds a way to get out of frame, like off the table. Anyway, Gus, why don't you tell us a little bit about the interface that people use to control Oscar?
Sure. So on Oscar is just a there's a tablet that's running a web server, and then that web server has some hooks that perform serial communication to the robot. And then in the Hangout app is just an iframe that is the target of four buttons, one forward, left, back, and right. And those and clicking those buttons will actually open the target URL inside of that iframe, and then the web server returns a sensor record for the bumpers and the wheel drop sensors and the cliff sensors. And I'm not entirely sure they're all working correctly right now because of a melting accident that occurred with Oscar.
Yeah, but, legend has it that Oscar had a short career as a battle robot that was not very successful, as you can see from the missing panels and scorch marks.
Well, the other robot was a lot bigger.
The other one was bigger? Yeah, you should have seen him.
You should have seen the other robot. So, it's probably a great time for us to play around with it, and you can see Oscar move across the table a little bit and explore the studio.
Cool.
And there's Lewis, who is our extremely helpful engineer for video.
Yes, and this is actually your first chance to see the studio in its entirety.
In its entirety.
So it's a special...
lots of cameras. And some box lights.
Cool. So, Gus, what happens when multiple people try and send different commands of the robot at the same time?
So what happens when multiple people send them at the same time, the web server that runs on top of the robot will just queue those commands up and then execute them as they came. Something that actually we were thinking about doing when creating the initial version was instead of just passing commands, because when the commands come in, they just send acceleration values or motor values to the two wheel motors on the Roomba. And what we were thinking about doing instead is just sending delta values. So, for example, if it were forward, you would send a delta value of 100 left wheel, 100 right wheel. If it were backward, it'd be negative 100 right wheel, negative 100 left wheel. And if it were, right or left, it would be, positive on the right side, negative on the left side. But actually, instead, if we were just sending delta values, then if everyone clicked at the same time, it would just make their change to the robot's current speeds.
Cool. So. Sounds like something we might want to add later.
Yes, definitely a V2 very, very early alpha. I don't know what comes before alpha.
Prototype.
Garage there we
stage.
Go.
Garage
stage.
Something
stage,
like that.
Yes.
Which Oscar is definitely in. Very sophisticated piece of machinery that Oscar is.
Cool.
So I saw that Oscar is in all caps. Does Oscar mean anything?
It does, and the acronym is hard for me to remember sometimes, but it's overly simplified, collaboratively actuated robot.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It's a great name.
So can we let Oscar go around the studio a little bit more?
Or? Sure. So we'll let Oscar move around the studio, and then we'll take some questions from the stream and from the Hangout.
Yep.
So, Devin, if you'd like to assist us. Devin's going to move the robot to the floor to reduce the risk of catastrophic robot failure
due to
falling. So you guys can explore the studio and the Hangout. And
yeah, it's a little bit hard to see.
He's stuck again.
He's already stuck?
It seems the controls are probably
Is it the surface that he's on, or?
He's on carpet.
It's the controls.
So a technical detail. I'm using a tunnel that actually has been crashing all morning. But it's a demo, and you know we have fun.
Yeah, it's one of the interesting features about controlling robots from a Hangout is robots are by their nature hardware devices, and Hangouts run inside a web browser. And bridging the communications between the web browser and a hardware device. Is often an interesting problem to solve. And the way we solved it with Oscar was by?
By using a service called Local Tunnel, and then just kind of using that service to map a global URL to the internal URL for the robot. So it's a proxy, and it's kind of a, I mean, in some, like it should be reliable, but it's really just kind of a beta service that's sort of a demo. So
yeah, that's always an interesting
demo. We get about, I think we've been getting about 5 minutes at a time at a time on there, and I'm not exactly sure why it goes down when it does. But
it's a great start for pieces hobbled together from your parents' basement.
Yes, absolutely.
Cool. Well, let's answer some of your questions. So, does anyone in the Hangout have a question for us about Oscar or for Oscar even? All right, let's see if there are any questions on the live stream. So a lot of people expressing the desire to meet Oscar. And you've met him now.
You've met him now. Devin, will you actually put Oscar back here? I'm going to make sure that it's not the web server that went down. It could be.
We're going to do some little poking around.
There you go, buddy.
Some poking. Hi, friend. Okay.
And no questions from the community yet. So if you have any questions, this is a great chance to ask us.
Yeah.
Or ask her.
Okay, so it is the tunnel, unfortunately.
So always the glue. Great.
So
have we inspired anyone out there, Gerwin or Emily, do you have any robotic plans for Google Plus platform?
Not yet.
Not yet. Well, hopefully we get those gears turning a little bit.
I'd love to see a Hangout plugin for the AR drones.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're actually pretty, what's it called? There's a term inside robotics which has to do with things that have recorded physical behavior that lets you basically... Instead of going move all these rotors in all these really complicated ways, you can basically just go left, and it will figure out how to do that for you. So because it has that, you could actually probably do something very interesting there by setting up a signal bridge between the two.
That is, AR drones and other quadricopters are definitely something we have tossed around the ideas. I mean, we've talked about them a little bit. They're really cool for that reason. The APIs that are available are pretty easy to use. But we decided to start with a terrestrial robot before we went with the avian variety.
Yes.
Yeah, I can imagine it would be... if the software were to crash, it would crash in a very particular and spectacular kind of way.
Yeah, it might take out several cameras as it goes out. It'd be pretty cool. Yeah. But...
And there's other interesting problems, too. Like, what happens when the batteries get low? It's flying, and it's got some...
Slowly
it's got... Yes, ideally...
I think I actually, yeah, it does have, it is actually self-preserving in that sense that it will try to land.
Oh, that's good.
Cool. Well, now that we have Oscar, we may investigate other modes of robot hangout transportation.
Yep.
Very cool.
Need more robots.
Yes. Yep. So yeah, I mean, absolutely. You could create a hangout very easily with any robot that can be controlled or actuated through a web server. And you could actually probably even use my app. So it's pretty simple, and there's like we have some documentation online on the inner workings of what it is specifically, and the source is going to be made available. For
That's
sure.
great. Yeah. So you mentioned that your application might be reusable. Can you explain how other people might be able to use it for their robots?
Sure. So so long as you have endpoints that are currently it's just forward, left, right, back, you can just change that URL to whatever your web server is, and so long as it responds to those, you can just put anything that can join a hangout on top of that, and then you'd be controlling the robot from a hangout.
Very cool. So if you want to see the source code that we're using to power that, we'll be putting that into the same repository that we put all of our Google Plus Developers Live code in, the office mm-hmm. hours repository, and it'll be up there soon.
Yep.
Great.
Great.
So thanks a lot for coming in to show us Oscar.
Yeah.
Unless anyone else has any other questions, I think we'll probably wrap it up for the day.
Yeah, thanks everyone for participating in the Hangout, too. It's great
Oscar
to have some...
The
unfortunately, the tunnel went down.
Yes, the tunnel went down. So I'm going to do... Oh, we actually have some comments from the stream.
Yes.
Could you show Oscar? So we'd like to get a little bit
a
more
better
of a close-up of Oscar for a second.
Sure.
All right, let's see if we can...
And if it would help for me to raise the robot a little bit.
There, you can get a really good view of Oscar. As I mentioned before, a very sophisticated piece of mechatronics machinery.
And
possibly the most advanced hangout robot in the world, maybe.
Yes. And there's the back.
Yes, the duct tape is coming in version 2.0.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is actually using binder clips at this point.
Yes, cardboard, paper clips, and binders.
Yes.
Clips. It's pretty sophisticated.
Very sophisticated.
Great. Okay, well with the close-up of Oscar.
The Oscar's close-up.
I think we're going to wrap it up for today.
Yep.
So thanks a lot, everyone, for tuning in. We'll have more regularly scheduled office hours. We'll be on our regular schedule, and hopefully we'll have some more of these special editions coming up.
Yep.
So thanks a lot for tuning in, and if you were waiting on the stream, thanks a lot for your patience as we got started.
Yep.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone. Thanks for watching.